Guys, to understand the conversion of Neumann projection to Fisher projection, we'll take an example. In this Neumann projection, this carbon is front carbon connected to H, OH and COH. This is the back carbon connected to COH, H and OH. If I try to write bond structure, it will look like this. Now you can see front carbon connected to COH, OH, H, back carbon connected to COH, OH, H. Now if I number 1, 2, 3, 4. Second carbon is chiral, third carbon is chiral. So with the help of bond structures, we can easily say there are two chiral carbon atoms. So Fisher projection will look like this. With two chiral carbon atoms, Fisher projection can be written like this. Now what are the different groups here that we have to identify? Guys, to convert this Neumann projection into Fisher, first we have to convert this Neumann projection into Sawhorse projection. Sawhorse projection, what will you do for that? Just stretch this second carbon and third carbon like this. Right. Now, this is the front carbon connected to COH, COH down, H left, OH right. Here, back carbon is connected to COH up, H left, OH right. Guys, one important thing you need to keep in your mind that if you want to convert Sawhorse into Fisher, then Sawhorse must be in eclipsed form. Why in eclipsed form? Let me draw. Guys, this is left, right, down. Left, right, down. If you take a torch and put light on this three-dimensional figure, you'll notice that the image that you get on Earth will be like this. This bond will be like this. These two bonds will open like this. And left, right, these bonds will open like this. Now you can see this is just a Fisher projection. So what we do for this Sawhorse projection, since here in the back carbon, the COH is up, so we'll rotate the molecule in such a manner that COH comes down. And since this bond is single bond, rotation is free rotation, so this rotation is allowed. So we'll rotate this molecule and we will convert that Sawhorse projection into eclipsed Sawhorse. OH will come here, H right. Now if you open this, COH will be here, COOH will be here, OH here, H here, H here, OH here. Now you can easily identify the groups attached. So I'll put here COH, OH this side, H this side, H this side, OH this side, COH. Now directly if you see this second carbon, front carbon is here, third carbon, which is back carbon, is here. Guys, now you can directly convert this Neumann projection into Fisher projection. Since here Neumann projection is in staggered form, first you have to convert this staggered form into eclipse form. Now what will you do for that? You will bring this COH down, and for that you have to rotate back carbon. So COH will be down, OH will be left and H will be right. And directly you can write the Fisher projection. Let me take an example. Guys, see this Neumann projection. Now we have to convert this Neumann projection into Fisher. So we'll draw two horizontal lines like this. This is the chiral carbon. This is the chiral carbon. This front carbon is here. The back carbon is here. राइट, फ्रंट कार्बन यू कैन सी मिथाइल डाउन, एच लेफ्ट सी एल राइट, सो आई राइट सी एच थ्री हियर, एच हियर सी एल हियर. फॉर बैक कार्बन वी कैन सी सी एच थ्री इज अप एंड वी नो दैट वी हैव टू कीप न्यूमैन प्रोजेक्शन इन एक्लिप्स मास, सो वी विल रोटेट दिस बैक कार्बन एंड वी विल ब्रिंग दिस सी एच थ्री डाउन एंड व्हेन यू डू दैट सी एल विल कम लेफ्ट, एच विल कम राइट, सी एल विल कम लेफ्ट, एच विल कम राइट एंड सी एच थ्री एट द टॉप. Now guys, you can also convert Fischer projection into Neumann projection in the same manner, just opposite way. What you do, you write a circle and front carbon is this one. Front carbon is this one and you can see H left, Cl right and CS3 down. And for back carbon you can write directly if you keep groups in eclipse manner like CH3 here, Cl here, H here, or you can convert this into staggered form just by rotating CH3 here, Cl will come this side, H will come this side, here it is H.